everybody. This is Gina Bear reporting to you for duty, and today I wanted to talk about how not to be a complete dickhead in Japan. So a lot of people come to Japan to see all the funky stuff from Tokyo, the samurai, the geisha, but in the process, they totally make an a-hole out of themselves. Recently, I was reading an article about some rude Chinese tourists that went and jumped in the sacred fountain at Kiyomizu-dera, and he was filling up his water bottle with the sacred water. And you can't do that because each of those three streams represents something different. So to drink from three means that you're super greedy and you can't have the good luck that those streams provide. I just wanted to let you guys know how not to be a dickhead in Japan. The first way, don't gaijin smash. What is gaijin smashing, you might ask? Gaijin smashing is imposing your will on the Japanese. I can't tell you how many people I've seen at the temples in Kyoto especially that don't want to pay the 500 yen entrance fee and just walk past the guards and just be like, oh, I don't speak English, and they just keep walking. Just pay the 500 yen, it keeps their temples beautiful and restores them when they need restoration. Don't be a dick, don't gaijin smash. The next one I wanted to talk about is don't litter. The Japanese are super clean. Japan is one of the cleanest countries I have ever been to slash lived in. And it's strange to a lot of people because there are no trash bins anywhere, so you're like, okay, where do I put my trash? If you have trash, keep it in a plastic bag, leave it in your bag until you can find a convenience store or a trash bin somewhere. Don't be a dick and don't litter. Japan should be kept pristine and clean because their own people keep it clean, so you should keep it clean too. Another thing is don't expect Japan to conform and bend to your will. The Japanese have done things the way they have for thousands of years, and they're not gonna change because of you. There's loads of websites and blogs that are dedicated to etiquette in Japan, so you should read up on those. I can give you a good example of how people want Japan to bend to their will and how this could have been avoided just by looking up some etiquette. For the Japanese, it's really rude to take money directly from you. So what they have is they have these little money dishes, so you put your money in the dish and then they take the money from the dish. So don't get all upset, you know, when you're like trying to hand them the money and they're just like, put it in the dish. It's just the way it is. Another way how not to be a dickhead in Japan is to use your indoor voice at all times. The Japanese don't like confrontation, so they won't directly be like, shh. Maybe some people will, but the majority of them will not. Don't be loud on the trains and the subways. I'm sure you guys have all heard that before, but you can tell who the foreigners are and who the people are that don't care about respecting Japan because they are so loud on the trains and the public transport. And even in public, use your indoor voice because it's not very polite to be loud. Another way you cannot be a dickhead in Japan is to wait your turn for photos. This should be common sense, but you'd be surprised. If you're trying to take a photo, the Japanese will wait their turn to take the photo. Don't cut in front of people just to take your photo. And another thing, be aware of your surroundings because people will be taking pictures and you know you could get in the way of their photo. And the Japanese are very mindful of who's taking photos and not to get in somebody else's picture. You guys should do the same thing. Don't be a dick, watch your surroundings, and don't get in people's photos. It's just not nice. I'm very pro women's rights and pro women's equality, and I really hate the stereotypes on Asian women. Just put it in your head, Japanese women are not these docile little sex kittens. There was an incident a while ago, I don't know if you guys remember Julian Blanc, where he walks into a convenience store in Japan and starts whispering rude things in this girl's ear, and this poor girl is just like, oh my god, what do I do? Don't be a dick and think that if you come to Japan, all these girls are gonna fawn all over you. Especially, this goes especially for the boys. And you can do whatever you want because of the way they're portrayed in Western media. Newsflash, treat women the way you would treat them in your own country. Treat them with respect, treat them with dignity, and don't be a dickhead. Just don't do it. I hate people who do that kind of stuff to any kind of woman because they don't deserve that. Don't be a dickhead. head and don't molest random women. These are just some things that you can do not to be a dickhead in Japan. If you're interested in reading about it, I wrote a post on my blog. You can check it out. I will leave a link in the description box below, and I have all sorts of things on how not to be a dickhead in Japan and how to respect the Japanese and make the most out of your trip if you're there or if you're living there. I hope this was helpful for you guys. And I want to know, what are your tips on how not to be a complete dickhead in Japan? Leave your comments in the comment box below. I'd be happy to read them and get back to them. And that's all for today. Jita Bear, signing out.